about the dashboard, we're going to spend quite a bit of time learning how to add content to your website. We'll start by adding a new post. But before we get started, you must first understand the difference between posts and pages. Posts are entries listed in reverse chronological order on the blog page, which is the homepage of your WordPress website by default. Posts must be filed under a category, and tags could also be assigned for further organization. Pages are much easier to understand. They contain static content that rarely changes. Unlike posts, they are not chronologically displayed in the blog page, and they cannot be assigned tags or categories. Pages are usually displayed in links or tabs at the header of websites. An About page, or a Contact Us page, is a typical example of what it's used for. If your website contains a blog, then you probably will be adding blog posts often. To create a new blog post, hover over the New tab in the toolbar and click on Post. You could also arrive at this Create Post page by clicking on the Add New Submenu link under Post in the main navigation. Similar to the dashboard, this page can be customized by clicking on the screen options and checking or unchecking the modules that you want to display on this page. You could also set the number of columns in which to display them. These modules could also be relocated and collapsed if need be. I'll start creating a post by entering a title in the title's input box. Notice that WordPress automatically generated a permalink to this post using the title I typed in. A permalink, also known as a slug, is a URL or web address where this post will be located. If you would like to edit the permalink, you can do so by double-clicking on the slug, which is highlighted in yellow. You can change it to anything you want, but remember, keep it short and simple. You can add content into the content input box by simply typing directly into it or by pasting content from another source. I'm just going to paste some generic content to save some time, and we can start formatting it by using the buttons in the edit pane. These buttons work much like the tools found in Microsoft Word or other similar word processing applications. For example, simply highlight the text you would like to format and click on the corresponding format button in the edit pane. You can bold, italicize, or strike through anything you want. WordPress also allows you to create unorder or order list and align your text left, center, or right. You can create block quotes, which are used to display quotes from other sources, such as someone's quote or a sentence from another website. You can create hyperlinks by simply highlighting the text that you would like your anchor text to be and clicking on the Insert Link button. In the pop-up window, enter the web address where you want to send your user and add a title. Titles are speech bubbles that display more information when a user hovers over the link. Then, check the box if you want this link to open in a new window or tab. You could also easily link to any existing content by clicking on Link to Existing Content. This drop-down menu reveals a list of your published content, including both pages and posts. To the right of the title, you can see if the selection is a page or a post. Posts display the published date, and pages simply read page. Selecting and clicking on any item will automatically fill in the fields above, then clicking on Add Link to create the link. Once a link is created, you can edit it if you like by highlighting it and clicking on the Create Link button once again. Or you can remove the link by clicking the Remove Link button. WordPress comes with a preloaded spell check utility with support for multiple languages. English is the default language, but if you would like to change it to something else, click on the down pointing arrow next to the spell check button and select the language of your choice. Then click the spell check button itself to perform the spell check. Words that are misspelled will have a red underline, and by left clicking on the word, you will get a list of suggestions for the correct spelling. Click on any of the suggested words, and the misspelled word will automatically update to the correct spelling. To get even more format and editing options, click on the Kitchen Sink button. This will reveal a second row of buttons in your edit pane. In this new drop-down box, you can set the format of your text by clicking on the down pointing arrow and selecting its proper format. In this case, for example, this is a headline, but I can change it to a paragraph. or even a block quote. The kitchen sink also added an underline text button, an align full button, and a text color picker to change the color of your text. If you're going to be pasting content from Microsoft Word, use the Paste from Word button. This is an extremely important step since Microsoft Word adds a lot of unnecessary code that you won't be able to see, but it could potentially create a lot of problems for you. Paste your code by simply holding Ctrl V on your keyboard and click on the Insert button. You could also choose to paste text without any formatting by clicking on the Paste as Plain button. To remove formatting that you apply to any text, simply highlight and click the Remove Formatting button. If you want to add a special character, such as a trademark, click on the Custom Character button and click on the special character you would like to add to your content. The Edit pane also gives you the ability to indent text right and left. And much like any other word processor, you can undo and redo any action you make by clicking on the Undo and Redo buttons. If you need help or have a question regarding the editor, click on the Help button to reveal the rich editor help documents. If you find that your content input box is too small, you can click and drag on the bottom of the right side of the box to increase its size, or you can make it smaller if you like. The bottom of the content input box also shows you the last time your document was saved and the current word count in your post. You also get an HTML path to your current selection. For example, if I click on this word, you will see that this word has a strong HTML tag applied to it and that it's inside a paragraph tag. If I click on the strong tag, it will highlight everything within that tag. And of course, the same will happen if I click on the paragraph tag. This can be useful for debugging glitches in your content or selecting the right type of tag to apply a new format to. If you prefer to work in a distraction-free environment, then you can switch to the full screen mode. This mode is a clean, clutter-free workspace. You will still have access to the basic formatting tools, but when your mouse is stationary, everything but the headline and content input boxes will fade away. You can exit the screen mode by clicking on the Exit Full Screen link on the upper left side of the screen. In the top right corner of the edit window, there are two tabs. One tab corresponds to the visual editor, and the other corresponds to the HTML editor. The visual editor is what we've been working on so far in this training series. It is a what you see is what you get, or WYSIWYG, rich text editor. Clicking on the HTML tab will enable the code editor. This is usually reserved for WordPress users who have experience editing HTML code. In this editor, you will see the HTML tags that make up your post. HTML tags are pieces of code which apply styles and format to your text. The HTML editor replaces the WYSIWYG's format buttons with quick tag buttons. They both work very similar, but you will only see the HTML tags that are applied. To add a quick tag, simply highlight the text you would like to edit and click on any of the quick tag buttons. Notice that WordPress automatically generated the appropriate open and closing HTML tag. Now that we've added all the text content to our post and applied the proper formatting, we need to start thinking about assigning a category to our post. Assigning a category is a mandatory step we must take before we publish this post. Categories are a good way of organizing or creating groups of posts with the same topic, which makes it easy for users to find relative content on your website. For example, if you're creating an internet marketing blog, some of your categories might include SEO, copywriting, or social media. You can assign or create categories directly from the category module. By default, the uncategorized categories assign. When creating a category, you can further organize your content by creating parent and children categories. For example, if you have a social media category, a child category might be Facebook. Keep in mind that you can add any post to as many categories as you like, but it's a good idea to keep them specific to the topic they contain. If you like, you can also add tags to your post, which are like keywords that further organize and describe your content. We will discuss categories and tags in further detail in other videos of this training series. The Format module allows you to determine how a post will appear on your site. a standard blog post, which will probably be your most used format, creates a post with a title and content paragraphs. An aside blog post will omit the title and only display the content. You could also display links, quotes, and a gallery of images. Keep in mind that these post types are not available on all themes. The Publish module gives you access to different posting options. If you're not ready to publish, but would like to save your work in progress, click on Save Draft. This will save your post, but will not publish it into your website. Clicking on the Preview button will open a new window, and you will see exactly how your post will look when published. The status indicates in what state the post is currently in. In this example, our post is a draft. If it were published, we could unpublish it by editing the status and changing it to a draft. The visibility of the post determines who can see the post. Public means that anyone who visits your post can view the content on the page. Checking the sticky checkbox will make this post appear at the top of your blog page, even after newer posts are published. Password protected will require users to enter a password to view the content on this post. Private makes the content only available to any logged in administrators to the site. By default, your post will be published immediately, but you can choose to automatically publish an article in a future date, or you can even backdate the post. Click on the Publish button to publish the post. Click on the View Post link that appear on the top of your page to check out the blog post we just created. For the most part, everything seems okay, but I want to make a few changes to this post, and also remove the comment box. Usually, it's a good idea to have comment boxes to create engagement in your content, but I don't want one for this particular article. To edit my post, I can click on the Edit Post link on my toolbar, or the Edit link next to the title of my blog post. Remember, both of these are only visible to logged-in administrators, not your visitors. The first thing I want to do is remove the comments on this blog post. To do that, I'm going to click on Screen Options and check the box next to Discussions. Then, scroll to the bottom of the page to reveal the Discussion module, and uncheck the Allow Comments checkbox. This will disable my comments only for this post. I want to take this opportunity to also show you how you can access and bring back previous versions of your post. This is done through the Revisions module. That could be activated in the Screen Options. The Revisions module shows you different versions of your post that have been created. You can revert back to any of these by clicking on the corresponding date. In this Revisions page, click on Restore and your blog post will be restored. Another way to edit and update your post is by going to the All Posts submenu in the Post menu items in the main navigation. This page shows all your posts. If you hover over any of them, you get a new set of links. That will allow you to edit, quick edit, trash, or view this post in the public view. Clicking on the quick edit link will give you a set of options in which you can edit your title, your slug, the publish date, add a password, set the page to private, assign categories or tags, allow comments or pinbacks, change the status and format of your post, and make this a sticky post. You can edit multiple posts at once by selecting the checkboxes of the posts you want to edit, and clicking on the Bulk Actions drop-down menu and selecting Edit. Any options applied in the Bulk Edit selection will be applied to all the posts you selected. If you accidentally selected a post you did not want to edit, click on the X next to the name of the post that you want to remove from the list. Now that you have a good understanding of how posts are created and edited, we can move on to understanding how tags and categories work.